Zack Ryder. Can any more people kiss the butt of Triple H around here?
Well, Triple H did manage to put this match together. The world champion Christian all set for action. Gonna go one-on-one with John Morrison.
Weighing in at 220 pounds, John Morrison.
And John Morrison returned from injury this past Monday night on Raw, seeking immediate retribution for the man responsible for putting Morrison on the shelf for a couple of months. That man was R-Truth. And speaking of R-Truth,
R-Truth's engaged in a great conversation with himself. I'd like to know, you know, the different characters that he talks to. I'd like to know if they're nice guys, if they're bad guys, good guys, funny guys, happy guys, sad guys. I'd really like to spend some time with R-Truth and get to know his alter, so to speak.
You know, R-Truth is back here on SmackDown, but I'm more concerned with this man right here, John Morrison, coming back off of a huge injury. And I'm gonna tell you, the hardest thing in this business is getting back in that ring off of an injury. You question yourself over and over again. Let's see exactly what happened.
You know what I'm concerned about?
What's that?
I'm concerned about the leadership thus far of the chief operating officer of WWE.
You're looking to get fired,
Triple
man.
H. Well, first
stay
off,
over there on that side, all right?
Booker, first off, if you remember what Triple H said on Monday, I have an ironclad contract. They have to pay me a ton of money if they were to fire me. Nonetheless, I would like to offer my opinion here.
Not if you quit, Cole.
When Mr. McMahon ran this company, he would negotiate. He would listen to both sides of the story.
So far, I haven't heard Triple H negotiate with anyone. In fact, he says he doesn't like to negotiate. He's not listening to people's sides of the story. He didn't even hear Christian out here tonight before he put him into this matchup and into the Orton match at SummerSlam.
I got a great idea, Cole. Well, after this match, won't you just go talk to him in his office? But right now, we got action going on. We got time.
Listen, I would love to talk to Triple H. I would love to have a discussion with him, but I'm afraid he put me in a goofy matchup.
I know why you're all upset, Cole, because Zack Ryder's here on SmackDown. He's the guy that kicked your butt this past Monday night on Raw.
You know,
in 3 seconds.
You know why that happened? Because Triple H forced me to wear his boots, and those boots were 4 inches bigger than my feet. I couldn't maneuver around the ring in my cat-like way that I normally do.
You know, I understand Triple H had to burn his gear. How much it stink after you got it back?
Well, you know, Heap's the one that forced me to wear his gear.
Triple H already making a tremendous impact here.
Whoa.
On Friday Night SmackDown as John Morrison goes for the cover here on the world champion Christian.
And what about this guy, John Morrison?
Check him out.
He shows up out of nowhere on Monday Night Raw and interrupts R-Truth's talk with the CEO of this company. John Morrison had no business rushing out here and attacking that man.
Ooh.
He was introduced by Triple H was John Morrison.
Come on, jeez. I mean, give it a break.
Right after
I mean, take
JR
a break.
Came back, another reason why you're all upset. I should say Hall of Famer. Good old JR. Can't wait to get your opinion on that poll when we return here to Friday Night SmackDown.
I will count. Back it up.
Back on Friday Night SmackDown, the world champion Christian in position here to defeat John Morrison.
Christian just rad-tagging this boy right now, man. Check this out right here. This is what I'm talking about as far as my concern with John Morrison. Did he come back too soon? That neck right now is in a whole lot of pain. Check him out.
Yeah, look, of course, you're alluding to the fact that John Morrison was just on the injured reserve list for over 2 months with an injured neck. Morrison returned this past Monday night to Monday Night Raw, and Christian has really gone after the neck of Morrison.
The thing is this, Josh, you know, you look at John Morrison, I mean, he's in great shape. He's looked better than I ever seen him before, but nothing can get you ready for that square circle except that square circle. Coming back tonight, first match, I got to give him a lot of props with how smart was.
Listen, are you guys missing the point here? Enough of John Morrison. What you need to talk about is the world heavyweight champion, Christian. He was blindsided tonight by Triple H. Not only was he put into this impromptu match against John Morrison, but have you guys forgotten that at SummerSlam, Christian's being forced to face Orton in a no-holds-barred matchup?
Have you forgotten what Triple H told Christian earlier? Triple H doesn't want to be interrupted by superstars. Triple H looks at that as tantamount to a slap in the face.
Well, you know, I can understand getting interrupted by normal superstars, but Christian's the world champion, and he should be able to have his say and give his piece whenever he wants to.
John Morrison, the parkour master.
Whoa,
parkour,
whoa.
The ability to use your environment to your advantage.
Booker, did the injured neck come into play there?
You know, I think it did right there, John. I don't think he got his full strength. Maybe working at 80, 85% right now. Not a bad move as far as being in here, but like I said, how smart is he? I mean, if you beat Christian tonight, it'll be big props. But I mean, if he hurt himself, he could be out for good. Wow, check that out.
And Morrison trying to build some momentum here.
Oh, wow.
Christian in control. Morrison down. Has Christian done enough?
And you know what that kip up just showed me, guys, at least in my mind and my estimation, is the fact that John Morrison trying to perhaps prove to himself, as well as everybody in the audience here tonight, that the neck is 100%. Maybe he's doubting himself, and he had to do something like that to prove it.
I'll tell you, what I see in John Morrison is totally the opposite. John is actually out here trying. Whoa, wait a minute. You see that? John is out here actually trying to pull off everything he did before he left. And I don't think it's a good thing to try to, you know, come back.
How spectacular was that from John Morrison?
I mean, that was a great move, but like, check him out right there. Look what he's clutching right there, the back of that neck. Like I said, I think he's hurt, man.
Well, of course, Christian's been railing on it all night.
Check this out.
I believe this will,
But again, Booker, I got to ask you about this.
Check it out.
If you have an injured neck, and it was seriously injured, you missed a number of months of action, why would you go pull off a move like that to get injured the neck even more?
You know, I actually talked to John Morrison.
Oh, spear! By the world heavyweight champion, Christian Morrison down and no, not out!
You know, I talked to John Morrison about, you know, coming out here doing some of the greatest moves I've ever seen him do before. But and will he come out here and try that stuff, just getting back into the ring? The guy told me, you know, ain't no use of just jumping in the small end of the pool. You jump into the big end and get it going. That's what John told me.
Well, John Morrison continues to clutch at the back of his neck as Christian, the world champion, gets caught by surprise.
Like I said, I really don't think it was a smart move, John, coming out here. But I'm going to tell you, the kid is putting up a hell of a fight against the champion.
It's also been a brilliant game plan by Christian to go after the questionable 100% neck.
Definitely, man.
John Morrison.
If I was Christian, I'd be all over that neck.
Dangerous situation here for both superstars.
Oh, man.
Wow. I don't like this right here. Christian's in a bad, bad position.
But John Morrison in a great position.
Oh, man, look at.
Wow.
Morrison was able to collect himself and land on his feet, but Christian gets the better of the exchange again to the back of the neck of John Morrison.
This has been brilliant. Brilliantly executed and by the world champion.
Kill switch.
My goodness.
Well, that's why Christian's champion.
Christian took advantage of the injured neck. Put that boy to sleep.
Here's your winner, the world heavyweight champion, Christian.
You know, the thing about Christian is he's not a big bruiser. He's not going to win many brawls, but he is as crafty and as sly as they come. That's the reason Christian is world champion today. And I believe at SummerSlam, he's going to find some way to beat Randy Orton in that no-holds-barred atmosphere.
Let me tell you, what Christian did was played on Morrison's weaknesses, just like this move right here. Slipped him and did just, oh my goodness, did you see it? Christian just hooked him up. And just put that boy to sleep. John Morrison, like I said, he did a hell of a job, but just couldn't get the job done.
Doesn't matter. Bottom line is Christian wins this matchup here tonight, and the world champion is rolling.
I agree with you, Cole.
Wonder what the new COO thinks of that. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we got wind of this earlier today that Jinder Mahal